Now, I want to introduce a few books that might be of interest. The beginning of Spanish settlement, not exploration. Exploration, I would recommend Kirkpatrick Sale, S-A-L-E, Kirkpatrick Sale, and his book called The Conquest of Paradise. That's the best of that nature. But when it comes to, you know, beginning to build a civilization, I want to recommend this one, Pioneer Jews, A New Life in the Far West. This begins with the famous land grant that was made by Spain to Moranos, to Jews who had at least pretended to be Catholic, and they were sent to the New World to begin this settlement here. Lyon, the Kingdom of Lyon, they called it. I want to show you this. It's huge. You can see that. Most of South Texas and virtually all of northern Mexico is the largest land grant that was ever given by a European potentate in the New World. And the story began, Jews were here, in other words, as civilizing entities before the pilgrims, because this is in early 16th century, before any other Europeans began building civilization, a century before, Jews, okay? And a lot of them, when they found out, when Spain found out that a lot of these Jews had returned to their Jewish faith, the Jews had to flee because more Spanish came over and took over the kingdom of León, and the Jews scattered, and they all over the Southwest. This is a fascinating book. You have to have it. Harriet and Fred Rochlin, or Rocklin, R-O-C-H-L-I-N. Very important. And then there is Los Comanches. Los Comanches. This is a book by Stanley Noyes. Noyes. N-O-Y-E-S. Noyes. It's very good. It covers the people from 1751 to 1845, the primo time period. It tells it more from the Spanish point of view. This is very important because the first European civilization that Comanches encountered, late as it was Spanish. Not white, I mean, not English, not American, not Anglo, Spanish. And the reason this is important is a lot of our first records, a lot of the first language lists, a lot of the first descriptions are from the Spanish point of view, and the pronunciation, the spellings of words that they claim are Comanche words, reflect Spanish pronunciation. This is how Comanches were introduced to the non-Indian world. It was through the Spanish. First, the Spain, the Castilians, and then the Mexican, which the Mexican civilization, of course, is a mix between the Castilians and some higher class Indian, Mexican Indians. And it's actually those the Mexican Indians, the blend of the Castilian and the Indian, that's the Mexicans, that's the Spanish culture that the Comanches first encounters. Because our first Spanish records of Comanches which we are positively sure that they were Comanches, is 1706. And Spain is still very strong. In fact, it's still New Spain at that time. Mexico had not gained its independence. But in the course of a century, as it became Mexico, and the Comanches became the lords of the southern plains, that's the history that most of us are more familiar with. Now, a couple of other books I'd like to recommend. This is very important, and it involves Plains Indians, but it doesn't involve Comanches, and that is Jews Among the Indians, and this is by M. L. Marx, M-A-R-K-S. He was an entrepreneur, businessman himself, a historian, really, and he introduces several different important Jewish men who, businessmen, and sometimes also diplomats, civil servants of the U.S. government, who encountered Indians. This is pretty rare. This is a rare find, and you need to, if you're interested in Comanche, in Indian history at all in the plains, this one's a treasure, along with the other Jewish Indian relations pioneer Jews. Okay, now there are other kinds of books which are not directly about Spanish, not directly about Indians, but you find statements, you find comments, you find incidental commentary about Indians. One such book is called The Alamo, and this is by John Myers Myers, M-Y-E-R-S. In the beginnings of his book, he points out that by the time of the Alamo, Comanches were, of course, dominant in the Texas, New Mexico, part of Oklahoma, and part of southeastern Colorado. The Comanches were dominant at that time. And he points out that until the Comanches came down out of the Rockies into that area, nobody had been able to drive out the Apache. The Apache were the first plague of the Spanish civilization, especially in Texas. He makes a statement that 300 years the Spanish had been trying to move the Apaches out, and they could not succeed. Comanches did it instantly. As soon as they came down, they drove out all the other tribes from the plains. And it's interesting how he dramatizes that. And this book is not about Indians and not really about the Spanish. This is about the Alamo. It's in background information. So you can look for interesting commentary and observation in history that has to do with that time and that area, but not necessarily directly with Indians. That's my point there. In the end, you have to put the pieces together yourself. Comanches are people that move around a lot. They don't like organized religion, and the religion of the Spanish is Catholic. It's like the antithesis of what appeals to the big game hunter. You have to stay in one place to be Catholic, not something the Catholics like to do. I'm sorry, not something the Comanches like to do. Catholics love it. But interestingly, Catholics are moving around all over the world, trying to get people to stay in one place. That's interesting.